Hello everyone, my name is Chiara and today I will be your guide while visiting Giocarlo Brignole Palace, which is today located in Piazza della Meridiana. The palace was built by Giovanni Battista Brignole in 1627, who entrusted for work blueprint the architect Bartolomeo Bianco. Although the current facade is a result of renovation of the 18th century, when the building site of Strada Nuovissima, now via Cairoli, was opened. Then the building became the connection point between Strada Nuova, now via Garibaldi, and Strada Nuovissima, now via Cairoli. The two telemons at the entrance are the work of one of the most important Genoese sculptors of the 17th century, Filippo Parodi. At that time they were inside a viridarium, a beautiful garden that stood right where today there is the Piazza della Meridiana.
I due artisti si occuparono dei quattro salotti che circondano i saloni di rappresentanza. Entriamo subito ad ammirare.
We now enter the rooms of the palace to discover the wonderful frescoes on the first noble floor, the artwork of the first decades of the 18th century by the famous painters Gregorio de Ferrari and his son Lorenzo. They were commissioned to decorate the four living rooms that surround the reception hall. We immediately admire the living room decorated with the Allegory of the Dawn by Gregorio. The room is placed to the east, in line with the decorative theme, being the first room to be illuminated by the sun. The decorative structure of the vault represents an elusive architecture culminating in an oval open to the sky, at the center of which there is the figure of Dawn, a young girl in a soft pink dress, whose final drape covers the part of the architecture.
Entriamo nel salotto successivo dove è rappresentato il mito di Diana e di Dione.
In the next living room, where the myth of Diana and Endymion is represented, we are welcomed by a nocturnal setting, unlike the Hall of the Dawn. In admiring the scene, it seems as if time has stopped. This is due to the detail of the two cherubs holding back the dog race, and the goddess abandoning her hunting weapons to admire her lover Endymion, represented on the opposite side of the vault, abandoned in a deep sleep. The detail of his leg descending and covering part of the painted cornice is a perspective fiction that creates an illusion about what the real and the painted space is.
La sala con il mito di Prometeo, che genera l'uomo, è l'unica stanza che fu decorata da Lorenzo, che aveva da poco terminato il suo viaggio di formazione a Roma.
The room in which the myth of Prometheus generating man is represented is the only one frescoed by Lorenzo de Ferrari, who had recently finished his training in Rome. The great complexity of the painted architecture is precisely the result of the study that Lorenzo was able to carry out in Rome through direct experience of the great vaults of the palaces and the churches of the Capitoline city. The perspective fiction begins with the wall marked by the decoration of a fictitious marble colonnade. Between the columns are painted marble busts on corbels with volutes, pilasters with monochromatic bas-relief decoration, and finally the overlay stucco bas-reliefs. The elusive architectural structure continues up to the vault where an open-air medallion opens up and houses the mythological scene. It is the story of Prometheus commissioned by Jupiter to create humanity, since Prometheus, a Titan, was the only one to side the Olympic gods during the struggle between gods and Titans. So Jupiter decided to reward him with this great feat. Prometheus is painted in the act of bringing the divine fire close to a marble statue, giving life to the statue itself. The naturalistic detail of the statue that gradually drips with the lifeblood is the highest technical expression of the painter. The god Athena supervises the entire scene. She was in fact the protector of Prometheus, but as well as the humanity and the intellect, which was the greatest talent of the Titan. Prometheus represents here the protector of humanity, bearer of great genius and valor, and it is precisely these qualities that are depicted on either side of the vault. The valor is represented as a young boy surrounded by the lion's mantle of Hercules, and the intellect as a young girl holding a compass in her hand, leaning against the armillary sphere. Prometheus' narration is nothing more than a ruse to celebrate the Brignole family through the allegory of the myth. The Brignole family, in fact, were not noble by blood, and they managed to reach the noble rank thanks to their gift, value, intellect, and just as Prometheus changed the fate of mankind, so the Brignole family was able to change the fate of the city of Genoa.
Riuscirono a raggiungere il patriziato genovese proprio grazie ai loro doti, al loro valore, al loro ingegno, alle loro grandi capacità pratiche, esattamente come Prometeo. E come Prometeo ha cambiato le sorti del genere umano, così i Brignoli hanno cambiato le sorti della città di Genova. Concludiamo la nostra visita.
And now the larger reception hall, which houses four busts of the family who owned the palace, the Brignole family and the Durazzo family, who bought it in the mid-19th century when they left their residence, the royal palace in Via Balbi, to the Savoia. These four marble portraits are a chronological synthesis of Genoese sculpture from the 17th to the 18th century, which was directly influenced by the Roman Baroque sculpture. The first bust we met is Gianluca Durazzo, the one who bought the palace in the mid-19th century, and is the work of Filippo Parodi, the one who had also made the thalamus of the Porto. He was a pupil of Gianlorenzo Bernini, and therefore a spokesman in Genoa of the Roman tradition, as demonstrated by the virtuosity and the chiaroscuro play with which the marble surface is treated. The second represents the founder of the palace, Giovanni Battista Brignole. The work is of the sculptor Fontanelli, a pupil of Filippo Parodi. The bust, however, is post-mortem. The artist, in fact, used a portrait by Bernardo Strozzi, which now is in the National Gallery in Dublin. The two other busts of the Durazzo family are that of Eugenio by Francesco Maria Schiaffino, one of the greatest sculptors of the 18th century, and that of Marcello Durazzo by Niccolò Traverso. It was the Durazzo family to want this rich, grotesque decoration for the atrium of the palace, which was once occupied by the garden. In the decoration we can see the Durazzo family coat of arms, while the lower part of the atrium is dedicated to the celebration of the city of Genoa. Here are represented the illustrious men of the city's history, like Guglielmo Imbriaco, Andrea Doria with Simon Boccanegra, who enclosed the scene of Ottaviano Fregoso destroying the Breglia fortress when Genoa was besieged by the French troops of Louis XII. The artistic language of this scene is typically risorgimental and patriotic in order to condemn the foreign invasion in any case.